What is horror? Can it be seen as something that only exists to make you quake in fear? Your anxiety picking at your brain as you stumble through a maze of fright? Or is it something far more nuanced and layered than anything we could ever hope to perceive? For some people see horror in myths of old, in monsters sculpted from the thoughts of madmen, or even in the very world we live in. But horror is persistent in nearly everything you are able to perceive. For as soon as something comes into existence, it brings with it the fear of the unknown. For something's true nature is only something that can be learned after extensive observation and obsessive persistence. So true horror can come from anything. From a fanged monster lurking in the shadows, a child actively asking you to watch Shark Tale with them, and even a show about a silly yellow sponge. The Bikini Bottom Horror is a SpongeBob webcomic created by Still in the Simulation. And when you hear a SpongeBob comic come anywhere near the concept of horror, a barrage of eye rolls is sure to follow after. At first glance, you'll probably be whisked back to the time of creepypastas like Squidward's Suicide, or the Rugrats Purgatory Theory, or the Ed and Eddie Purgatory Theory, or the Invader Zim Purgatory Theory, or the Courage the Cowardly Dog Purgatory Theory. And Jesus, dude, these really were everywhere, weren't they?
I'm done.
What?
I'm bored. You're boring me.
But I am happy to announce that not only does the Bikini Bottom Horror manage to create an excellent premise, the execution of that premise is handled with a masterful use of horror tropes and surprisingly meme culture. So let's take a look at it and figure out why this is one of the best pieces of fan fiction I've ever read. It starts off innocent enough with SpongeBob asking Patrick if he's okay. But literally in the next panel, the tone of the comic is set in stone. This is not going to be a feel-good story. I mean, unless you're into some of this stuff, dude. No wrongs, just right. The switch is immediately flipped when Patrick's body splits open and ends the poor sponge's life in a surprisingly gory, yet educational, display. Good night, you sweet goofy goober. I hear the bubbles never pop in heaven. That's right, SpongeBob is killed in literally the first page. They killed the personification of joy in the show as soon as they could, and it was such a good move. I mean, it's SpongeBob. He's not supposed to die. He's the hero, the goofball, the knucklehead McSpazitron, and he just freaking beefed it. But by killing him off immediately, you know that anything goes in this world, and no one is safe. Instead of following SpongeBob, Sandy is the main character. You see her fighting off Patrick, and at first you think she's won, but here's the thing. Starfish can regenerate. Soon the world is overrun with Patricks. Sandy tries to find shelter with Mr. Krabs, but there is a connection with Krabs and Patrick that I won't dare spoil. Let's just say that it makes perfect sense, and that's what's so horrifying about it. Sandy ends up with Squidward of all people, who is looking good, my dude. Dang, man, the apocalypse has been kind.
He's got those things. What do you call them? The gutters.
Morty, gross.
That's what people call them.
Gross.
Together, they end up fighting against Patrick, uncovering dark secrets and overcoming personal doubts along the way. There is something about this story that just works. It's got bits of so many things in it. Body horror, zombie movies, eldritch monstrosities. But it all just meshes together in the SpongeBob world. A lot of it is tied together by something that we often overlook in SpongeBob. They are animals, and animals are the scariest thing. Everything Patrick does in this comic is something that Starfish can do in real life, and the acts of horror that he commits are rendered in disturbingly lifelike detail. And in the scale of SpongeBob, the things that he can do can be seen as grotesque. Like, man, dude, I learned a lot about starfish reading this, but I'm sure the nightmares will wipe that slate clean. You always hear stuff like, man is the real monster. Like, with all our wars and stuff, and yeah, sure, I get it. But, like, people are a lot scarier in the long term than the short term. Like, what would freak you out more? The threat of a nuclear war 100 years into the future? Or a lion ripping your face off right now? Yeah, I thought so. Man, animals are scary. I'm glad we eat them. But aside from the masterful way horror is integrated into SpongeBob's environment, there's also the fact that this comic is meme central. But not like in an, oh my god, he did the SpongeGar face lol way. Like, the recognizable memes are integrated in this story in a believable way. Like, the Patrick face makes sense when he's doing such despicable things. And making Leetle Leetle Lee into a Cthulhu-esque chant was genius. This comic not only subverts SpongeBob into a horror classic, but it also celebrates the legacy of the source material. And you haven't even talked about the art? And I haven't even talked about the art yet! The entire comic looks like it's done traditionally, which helps with the gritty nature. The cross-hatching gives the art a dreary and real feeling that elevates the entire thing. A lot of it can come off as a little amateurish, but the artist clearly knows their strength and uses that to compensate. Like the close-ups of Patrick's anatomy or the scenes where the characters become more realistic are spectacular. I couldn't believe I was tensing up in fear reading a comic where this guy is the villain. The writing in this comic is also pretty good. There's a lot of obvious jokes thrown in here and there, but Patrick's speeches are generally threatening, and there's even a few one-liners that hit me in a way that I would not have expected. So far, the comic is only about 30 pages long, divided into seasons 1 and season 2, so I inhaled it in about an hour. Season 3 is on the way though, so do not sleep on this. I'll leave a link down below if you want to check it out for yourself, which I highly recommend you do. The Bikini Bottom Horror is some of the most fun I've ever had reading a comic. So if you like horror, and I know you like SpongeBob, give it a read. Now if you excuse me, I have a fish tank I need to get rid of. Safety first, guys. I can't die, but why take a risk?